In this video, we will be looking at the vision of the ram and the goat. Remember how the vision of the beast in chapter 7 was received in the first year of King Belshazzar. And now, in the third year of King Belshazzar, that is 2 years later, Daniel received the vision of the ram and the goat. It must be remembered that most of chapters 1 to 7 were written in Aramaic, and chapters 8 to 12 were written in Hebrew. We will find how the latter section concerns more particularly the house of Judah and the coming Messiah. This will be seen more clearly as we go further into Daniel chapter 9. Let's begin with a vision of the ram and the goat as we read verses 3 to 8. Then I lifted my eyes and saw, and there standing beside the river was the ram which had two horns, and the two horns were high, but one was higher than the other, and the higher one came up last. I saw the ram pushing westward, northward, and southward, so that no animal could withstand him, nor was there any that could deliver from his hand. But he did according to his will and became great. And as I was considering, suddenly a male goat came from the west, across the surface of the whole earth, without touching the ground, and the goat had a notable horn between his eyes. Then he came to the ram that had two horns, which I had seen standing beside the river, and ran at him with furious power. And I saw him confronting the ram. He was moved with rage against him, attacked the ram, and broke his two horns. There was no power in the ram to withstand him, but he cast him down to the ground and trampled him, and there was no one that could deliver the ram from his hand. Therefore, the male goat grew very strong. But when he became strong, the large horn was broken, and in place of it, four notable ones came up towards the four winds of heaven. Daniel chapter 8 verse 20 to 21 clearly gives us the interpretation of the ram and of the goat. The ram having two horns are the kings of Media and Persia. The horn being one higher than the other speaks of the Persian kingdom who had become higher than the Medes in time. The male goat that came from the west is the kingdom of Greece. It had a notable horn between its eyes and speaks of Alexander the Great as the first king. In this vision, we are told how the goat overpowered the ram, cast it to the ground, and trampled him. This is confirmed historically when the Grecian kingdom conquered Medo-Persia and became the next world empire. We are also told how this goat grew strong, and when he became strong, the large horn was broken, and four horns came into its place. History also tells us how Alexander the Great conquered the then ancient world in a very short amount of time and died at the height of his power. After his death, the kingdom of Greece was divided among his four generals known as Cassander, Lysimachus, Seleucus, and Ptolemy. Cassander took Macedonia and the western part. Lysimachus took Thrace, parts of Asia, and the northern part. Seleucus took Syria and the eastern part, and Ptolemy took Egypt, Libya, Arabia, and Palestine and the southern part. Note how the leopard with four heads and wings of a fowl in chapter 7 spoke of the Grecian Empire and corresponds to the male goat, Greece, with its notable horn being broken and four coming out in its place. We are now told that out of the four horns came a little horn. In other words, out of the four kingdoms that were divided among Alexander the Great's generals came out a little horn which grew exceedingly great towards the south, the east, and towards the glorious land. It says in verse 10, "And it grew up to the host of heaven, and it cast down some of the host and some of the stars to the ground and trampled them. He even exalted himself as high as the prince of the host, and by him the daily sacrifices were taken away, and the place of his sanctuary was cast down. Because of transgression, an army was given over to the horn to oppose the daily sacrifices, and he cast truth down to the ground. He did all this and prospered." Let us look at what this little horn is like. Number 1. It grew up to the host of heaven. Number 2, it cast down some of the host and some of the stars to the ground and trampled them. Number 3, he even exalted himself as high as the prince of the host. Number 4, by him the daily sacrifices were taken away and the place of his sanctuary was cast down. Number 5, he cast truth down to the ground. Number 6, he did all this and prospered. And number 7, he has fierce features. Daniel chapter 8, verse 23 to 25 gives us further insight into who this little horn is. Number 1, we are told that he is a king. Number 2, he understands sinister schemes. Number 3, his power shall be mighty, but not by his own power. Number 4, he shall destroy fearfully. Number 5, he shall prosper and thrive. Number 6, he shall destroy the mighty and also the holy people. Number 7, he shall cause deceit to prosper under his rule. Number 8, he shall exalt himself in his heart. Number 9, he shall destroy many in their prosperity. And number 10, he shall even rise against the prince of princes. Daniel chapter 2, the image dream, and chapter 7, the beastly vision, give us the order of the world kingdoms from Babylon right through to the antichristal kingdom unto the second coming of Christ. In Daniel chapter 7, Daniel sees a vision of a little horn that would arise out of the 10 horns of the terrible fourth beast, which is Rome, and wears out the saints of the Most High. In Daniel chapter 8, Daniel sees another vision which involves a little horn who stands against the host of God, casts down some stars to the ground, stamps on them, and casts truth to the ground. But this little horn arises out of the divisions of the Grecian Empire. The big question is, who is this little horn found in Daniel chapter 8? Could this little horn be the same little horn mentioned in Daniel chapter 7 who was identified as the personal Antichrist? The answer is yes. Daniel chapter 8 provides progressive revelations about the same world kingdoms given in chapter 2, the image dream, and Daniel chapter 7, the beastly vision. In the next video, we will be taking a closer look at this little horn and how it not only finds a measure of fulfillment in history, but ultimately points to the personal Antichrist.